is Brenda. I had an accident in the Kruger National Park. I had received a bit of bad news and I needed to get to my ex-husband, who was a trails ranger at the Sweeney Trails Camp, to talk to him about it. And this is what made me leave the camp at that strange hour. He didn't know that I was on my way to him, and no one in the camp of Sitara knew that I was leaving. And just at dusk, around about 5 to 5:30, kudu jumped in front of me. I swerved to miss the kudu. I hit the culvert and the vehicle rolled.
Die feit dat 'n kudu voor 'n voertuig inspring, is in 'n groot mate 'n instinkreaksie en 'n skrikreaksie. Kudu sien nie vir jou nie, hy sien die lig aankom, hy skrik, instinktief spring hy en ongelukkig tref hy gewoonlik die voertuig.
I was luckily thrown out. When I came around, the vehicle was a little ways away and I tried to get to it. I knew that was going to be the safest place to be. You know, at the time, it was terrifying, it was cold, it was painful.
Om in die aande in die Kruger-Wildtuin gestrand te wees, kan nogals 'n vreesaanjaande ervaring wees. In die eerste plek, 'n mens is baie kwesbaar. Toproofdiere is besig om rond te beweeg in die bos. So in die eerste plek sou ek sê, bly waar jy is. Moenie begin rondstap en hulp soek nie.
I managed to drag myself to the vehicle and lay up against it. Unbeknown to me, this muscle had been ripped out. My shoulder had been badly injured. It had to be eventually replaced. I had ribs in my lungs and injuries to my hips and legs.
Sy was beseer geweest, so sy kon in elk geval nie rond beweeg nie. Vir haar was die belangrikste om in die wrak van die voertuig te kom so vinnig as moontlik, want as sy binne die voertuig gestaan, is sy in 'n relatiewe veiligheid.
I lay against the car listening. Out of the corner of my eye, a civet started moving in. And she was making a very deep, deep, sort of a booming, mewing sound.
A civet het 'n baie goeie reuksintuig. Hulle loop met hulle neus na in die grond, baie tipies van 'n civet. En ek vermoed ja, die feit dat daar wel bloed in die area was, het gemaak dat sy gedink het hier kan sy moontlik nou iets te aas kry. Ons weet baie min eintlik van die geluide van civet, veral wilde civetkatte af. Daar's 'n paar geluide beskryf, onder andere die laaggromgeluid. As die kat ongemaklik voel, dan kan hy daai laaggromgeluid maak. En die kleintjies het tipies 'n mew geluid van 'n huiskat wat hulle ook maak.
And she was eventually just a little ways away from me, so I decided to chat with her. It was the thing that was going to keep me awake. I couldn't afford to sleep. And I think that civet was my guardian angel for the night. Like, keep awake, keep calm.
Alhoewel ons nie uit 'n wetenskaplike hoek die snaakse gedrag van die civet kan verduidelik en hoekom die civet vir soveel ure by Brenda gebly het nie. Hulle is nie sosiale diere nie. Nie eens met mekaar, met hulle eie spesies nie.
Somewhere in the middle of the night, she jumped up and she moved off. And her hyenas were coming along. And luckily for this injury, they were taking their time, but I pushed myself into the back seat of the vehicle. The hyenas got outside. Of course, there was a nice pool of blood where I had been lying. And they were whooping and having fun. I can still smell those hyena, okay? There was one of them that decided to have a look around the other side of the buggy. And it went around the buggy and it grabbed my boot and it started yanking. Well, I used up all my adult language. I kicked because I was not going anywhere with that hyena.
Ja, so gevlekte hyenas het hierdie ongelooflike groot skedel en kaakbeenspiere. Juist met die idee om deur daai groot bene te kan byt onder die beenmerg uit te kom, wat geweldig voedselryk vir die dier is. Hyenas het 'n baie goeie sin vir reuksintuig en hulle het die vermoë om karkasse in die veld op te spoor.
I kept darting and trying to grab and trying to pull me out, but I was clinging to roofs and being really ugly to it. And eventually it left, and so did the others. And I just lay there in the absolute silence, thinking like, no, that was okay, I'm alive, and the civet came back. And she was now sitting just outside the headrest. And she just kept making her noises. And eventually it went quiet. And absolute terror hit me. I thought, no, why is she gone now? And it was really turning grey. It was morning. So I pulled myself out of the vehicle. And I didn't quite know where the road was, so I just waited until I could hear. But then some youngsters came along. They jumped out, they grabbed me, put me in their combi, and took me back to Satara. They got me to the hospital. I got this cleaned out the first time in theatre. Second time in theatre, they replaced my shoulder. And here I am.
Dis natuurlik baie belangrik om indien jy ooit in die nag in die Kruger of in enige ander park moet ry vir 'n noodgeval of vir wat ook al om wel vir mense te sê dat jy is nou op pad so en toe en jy gaan so laat terug wees. Moenie ry sonder om vir iemand in kennis te stel van waarheen jy gaan en hoe laat jy gaan terug wees nie, veral as daar nie selfoon ontvangs is nie.
Now I actually go out and I enjoy every minute because hey, I face the hyenas. And I came out the other side, so that there's something that I can do every single day that's different. Okay.